When you think about the artists that inspire you and you listen to some of your favorite solos of theirs, are the opening lines similar or is it different every time? One of my favorite starts of a solo is Frank Rosolino on Don't Take Your Love From Me. It's so heartfelt somehow. The song is about the person that would be completely broken if he would lose his loved one. And to me, the opening of the solo really emphasizes that. It's like, don't leave me, I can't live without you. But I think solo beginnings also can be interesting if they do the opposite, be surprising and contrasting. I really recommend listening to a few starts of solos and then writing down your own. When we improvise, it's like we are composing real time, but it can be a great learning experience actually composing some lines beforehand. Of course, the most fun is if you can surprise both the audience and your fellow musicians, and you don't have to use anything you have written down, but sometimes better safe than sorry, and it's nice to have some phrases in your back pocket just in case. Another nice way to start your solo is to extend or continue the theme, you know, something like this. A simple and organic way to do it. Or like Swedish piano player Tommy Kotter here in Sonny Rollins' Cutie. So nice. You can also start playing the melody, especially if it was presented by someone else, if you played in a larger ensemble, or if you're playing with a singer. Just playing the melody can be a great start of a solo, like Kenny Dorham does on Blue Bossa. If you are not the first soloist, there is a long and fun tradition in jazz to pick something up in the previous soloist's last phrase and use that to start your solo. Another example is J.J. Johnson picking up just two notes of Miles Davis' last phrase on the blues Walking. Now, when you play a slow blues like this, you have to be careful when you use the tonic major third, especially in the second bar, because if you're not on the same page as the rhythm section, the piano player or guitar player might play a 4 chord with a flat 7, and that's not a beautiful clash at all. But I love JJ's kind of casual humor here. It's like, yes, I played an A, deal with it. A third example is Steve Turay taking the solo after Woody Shaw on You and the Night and the Music. Here he's not echoing any specific notes, but instead the concept of chromatic approach notes. Beautiful start of a solo. Check out this video if you haven't already, and let me know in the comments your favorite starts of solos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.